So, hello everybody, and I'm quite grateful to present some of my preliminary results of my PhD thesis. And so I will show a little bit settlement patterns in my research area, and I'm using almost the same methods like Knut for pattern analysis, so kernel based density, and also with decay in the background to interpret a little bit more. I will also have a quick look at the total distribution, not only the settlements, but everything that we have from my different time slices. And then I will do a predictive modeling, but at this stage it's more for questions about why my data is patterned like this. It's not so much about where I have to look in the future to find new settlements. That is something for the future. So, my thesis is part of the Beethoven project. It's a project that's supported by the Polish National Science Center and the German Research Foundation, and based at the University of Kiel and the University of Poznan. It's about the late Neolithic and early Bronze Age developments in the southwest Baltic area, and especially about the question, why did Buševo, so we heard about it earlier from Luther, this Buševo's fortified settlement, and Veliki Mawe, that's quite famous, I think, in Bauer Cemetery of the early Bronze Age unities of culture, why do such power structure appear? Or, in my case, more or less, why do they not appear in our region? So, we are in northern Germany, that's Mecklenburg-West-Pomerania and northern Brandenburg for now. And the whole research project is interested also in the north Polish part, so Kujawi. I will present to you now some results from Mecklenburg-West-Pomerania and northern Brandenburg, and we'll compare it to the small cost-sharing region with Veliki Mawe and Buševo and that. I think we can't see it really good. Here is more quality table. I will compare my early Bronze Age, so from 2200 around to 2600-2500 of Mecklenburg and northern Brandenburg, with the Middle Bronze Age or older Bronze Age, so period 2 and 3 after Montelius, from 2500 to 1500 to 1100. It's more or less the same chronology in Greater Poland or around Buševo, so from 2200 to 1600 the early Bronze Age, and from 1600 to 1100 more or less the Middle Bronze Age. And my initial question was, during the Middle Bronze Age, I have really few houses in my area. But in the preceding Early Bronze Age, there are now quite a few houses. So the question is, why is that so? And how we can compare it? So I will compare it with the corded rare culture or single graph culture, because that's also a period where we have not so much houses, but a lot of finds otherwise. So first, the blue dots in my North German area are settlements of the corded rare culture. We have around 102. The red squares are the settlements of the early Bronze Age, and the orange pentagons are settlements of the older Bronze Age, middle Bronze Age. From early Bronze Age and older Bronze Age, we have around 50 settlements. So let's look at the kernel density estimation for the corded rare culture. We have a high density in the lower order region, so the order Schnuckeramik is here based, and also in the southwest, but not so much at the coast. That changes to the early Bronze Age, where we have two settlement centers in the northwest of Mecklenburg, around the Lake Schwerin and in the area of the river Warnow, south of Rostock, so here. And which, as you can see, quite a few settlements in the lower order region. So there's a real shift. Looking at now at the older Bronze Age or Middle Bronze Age, we have in the Northwest quite the same pattern. But we can also see that the coast gets more important, especially here around the Strelasund in Rügen. What we can also see, if we compare the values of the current density estimates and show the distribution of settlements per square kilometer, is that there's a real decrease of density from the early Bronze Age to the middle Bronze Age. So the settlements of the middle Bronze Age are quite more dispersed compared to the early Bronze Age. If we compare it with the total distribution, we can see that there's more or less the same compared with every stray find, burial, and hoard we can find, the distribution of that. For the early Bronze Age, also for the middle Bronze Age, but we have also this real concentration on Usedom in the east. That's not visible in the settlement distribution for now. Let's compare quickly with the Kaohsiung region, where we have for the coated red culture again, the blue dots, and we have around 495. For the early Bronze Age, the split squares again, it's around 230. And as you can maybe not see, there are exactly two middle Bronze Age sites in this region. So there's a real change, I would say. But we can also say a change in the pattern of the distribution of the sites, of the settlement sites. In the coated rare culture, we have east-west distribution in the south of our Richards area here. That changes to the early Bronze Age, more northwest, north-south distribution. And what we can also see is that the deep valley of the Ober River gets more important. So now we'll come to the predictive modeling. And so we have seen structures before in the kernel density estimation and so on. And spatial structures are, according to Loew, kinds of social structures, so it makes sense to look further to them. I will use a predictive model, and all predictive models have, according to Whitley, one thing in common: they are expressions of a probabilistic relationship between human behavior and prior existing spatial conditions. These spatial conditions are not only environmental parameters, so not only slope aspect, I will talk about that shortly later, but also social connections that we can look at with complexity modeling or network modeling and everything else. That's also something that can be put inside a predictive model. So prediction in this case is a description. What is where, who is where? Post-prediction, that's what I want to do now with my predictive model, is to explain the explanation why is something that I found somewhere is positioned where it is positioned. So, as I said, it's preliminary results that I present today, so I will just focus on the environmental part of the predictive modeling. So keep that in mind when you look at the results, that it's not the final results, but that's what that's the environment that the people in the Bronze Age and the Coated Ware had to work with, or worked with, let's say it like that. But there's a whole part of deductive modeling to the predictive modeling that's missing for now, and we'll add it later. So my first results for the coated ware culture are, and I think you can see it quite clearly, the red color indicates the highest probability of settlement positions, and they are really in the vicinity of rivers. On the low area of the rivers, so on the wet areas, there's the highest probability to find a recorded rare culture settlement. If we now compare to the early Bronze Age, we can see that not the rivers are the sought for places anymore, but the slopes above the rivers. So there is a shift in the preferred settlement. I'm quite unhappy that I can't show you the distribution for the Middle Bronze Age because of what's the calculating where I had to leave for here. But we can talk about the influences and the significance of the influences of the parameters in the predictive model because that was easier to calculate. So for the digital elevation model, so the heave, the overall heave, it's for every region, it's shown that the overall, they prefer lower areas, but that's only significant for the early Bronze Age. All other time periods, they look for them, for the lower areas, but it's not the primary decision marker. If we look at the slope, we can see that it's difficult to interpret for the early Bronze Age and for the recorded rare culture. This means that there's not a uniformity in the distribution of the settlements. So we can think about different roles for the settlements. But for the Middle Bronze Age, there's a clear preference for gentle slopes. So more or less every settlement looks for the same place. If we look at the aspect or the cardinal direction of the slopes, we can see it's not significant for every time period, but recorded rare culture, early Bronze Age and Middle Bronze Age are not looking for northern-oriented slopes. And the real difference is that neither the recorded rare culture nor the early Bronze Age are looking for southwestern-oriented slopes, but in the Middle Bronze Age, we can see that they are quite looking for them. So there seems maybe to be a shift also in the economy, or at least in the preference where I do my economy, my subsistence economy, that is. Looking at the topographic prominence index, that's to ask the question, is my settlement in a flat area, on a slope, or on a ridge? We can see also again that for the recorded rare culture it's difficult, and in the Bronze Age they prefer slopes and flat areas. That's quite a significant point. And what's also interesting is that in the recorded rare culture there's a preference for less windy areas, while in the Middle Bronze Age and Early Bronze Age they prefer windy areas, and it's also quite significant. So we can think about maybe that's a question of the permanence of the settlements, because for the recorded rare culture we think more about seasonal settlements in contrast to the more permanent settlements of the early Bronze Age or the Middle Bronze Age. So come to my conclusion. I think there's quite clearly a shift in the early Bronze Age of the settlement concentration from the lower order to the West Mecklenburg area. We can also see that the settlements concentrate in the northwest during the Middle Bronze Age, but also show a stronger connection to the coast. If we compare it with the Kaohsiung region, there is also a similar trend that there's a shift in the pattern, but it's quite clearly not the exactly same shift. It's also quite clear that the concentration of settlements is really, really different, because we have a much higher concentration of settlements in the recorded rare culture and in the early Bronze Age in the Kaohsiung region. And we have quite clearly not so much decrease in the concentration of settlements in the Middle Bronze Age in northern Germany. And I think the last point is more a question at the method, and I think there's predictive modeling is in this way a usable tool to assess influence and significance of different environmental parameters, but for the future, the social parameters have to be added. So, thank you.